I'm really happy that I got this icebreaker speech. I try telling one line about myself to my husband and get so worked up. And now I have an audience full and six whole minutes. That's lovely. It's a lovely day, Children's Day. I wish my son was also here. He had cricket coaching in school, so he couldn't come. But also, you know, there was this little nervousness in me because all children are natural reporters. They don't need a journalism course. You know, I was a little anxious that, you know, everything will be reported back home. Anyways, so it's like, I come from Beltanadi Taluk, which is in South Canada. And I did my BA in SDM College, Ujire. That's like 10 kilometers from the temple town of Dharmasthala. Then I did MA from Mangalore University. And then in search of a job, we went to Mangalore town. I worked as a part-time lecturer there. Then I was lucky to get a job with Times of India as a reporter cum editor. Like here, you'll have a Bangalore Times edition. So we used to have a Mangalore Plus edition. So it was about lifestyle, health, trends, education, and the like. So it was like soft reporting. And I thoroughly enjoyed the 1.5 stay there, mainly because of the fact that I came to meet so many people from different walks of life. People, you know, having varied experiences. And it is one such lady whom I met, Seema Rao, who took me to my first Toastmasters session. And I so thoroughly liked it. And I wanted to be a part of it. That's why even when I moved to Bangalore, I came pursuing it. And lucky that I got an open to all club here. Then after marriage, I moved to Bangalore. And it's like I've been a housewife. And it's been in the past 2 months that this thought has been coming very much to me, you know, that I am a nothing. I am a zilch achiever. I have nothing to tell as my profile. Like when we sit, the other day when we were sitting, I was sitting with my friends. One lady said she's an artist. And somebody asked her, what artist? And she said, I'm an abstract artist. Somebody else is in software. She has a nice portfolio, she was telling. And then somebody is in a bank. So all my friends have some kind of a, you know, they can, or as an executive or something. I'm feeling that kind of vacuum now, you know, housewife. That was good when my mother said it. In this age, I'm not saying it's empty. Because I thoroughly enjoyed these past many years when I was sitting at home. I have a huge big house. So maintaining the garden, keeping it clean, organizing, seeing that every room is tidy is not easy. So I enjoyed that part. Especially because my husband's job entails him to travel 150 days in a year. And he travels to so many countries. I also have a lot of people coming in at home. So till now, taking up a job is not that easy. Like last month I had people from Zimbabwe. I had people from South Africa. Before that, I had people from Australia. I had people from so many different countries. And I host lunches, dinners, and I'm very passionate also about it. Like, what do you get in the best restaurants? You know, the way things are presented in restaurants, I work very much with that. Almost like a pro. The way I work on the starters, the desserts, the way I present food. So much so that once, somebody had come home and after they left, my husband said, why don't we start a restaurant? And I said, no. Because when people come home, I do it, you know, I put my heart, soul and mind. But if I take it professionally, I think that pensions will be gone. I cannot do it day-to-day basis. Then, Toastmasters, I'm here. Then I want to get into a running and a trekking group. I'm already into yoga, meditation, pranayama. I'm into Lalita Sahasranama reading. I invite a lot of ladies home. But with running and trekking though, you know, I think it's something that's picked up very recently and not in a place like Bangalore, but a lot of friends my age, they tell me that they took to it and now they've ended up with broken heels and fractured ankles and things like that. So I have decided that even if I join, I'm going to go slow because I don't have a point to prove to anybody or I don't have to shine in a marathon anymore. But yes, I'm doing something. Then I have 2 books which I've been thinking for long to write. I've not been able to get to writing. Although the thought, almost page 1 to the last page is in my mind, I've not been able to put it on paper. Partly because I think the challenge is not that of conviction. The challenge lies in consistency of efforts on a day-to-day basis. but I'm very determined. As is general knowledge, all of us have only one life to live. We have to give it our all. Every moment has to be cherished. I always spent like 36 years believing I've not done anything. So in whatever time I have, I know I should put all of my effort and make the most of this life. Because that's all I've got, and I think I have got a lovely life and I only need to make it better. So that's my story, and thank you.